Hello children, in this video I am going to teach you the first chapter, Numbers, of your Star Max book. The topics covered in the chapter are abacus, number names and numeral, face value and place value, successor and predecessor, expanded form and short form, comparison of numbers, ascending order and descending order, greatest number and smallest number. To start with, I am going to teach you the difference between numbers and digits. What are numbers? Numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and so on. Why do we use numbers? We use numbers for counting. So these numbers are called counting numbers. And digits are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. What is the difference between numbers and digits? Numbers are endless. There is no end to numbers. But digits are definite, which means there are only 10 digits. Using the digits, we form numbers. What is a one-digit number? If we use the digit only once, they are called one-digit numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Does 10 come under one digit number? No, because there are two digits. Have used the digits twice. So 10 comes under two digit numbers. So after 10, so digits are the, we make use of the digits to form numbers. So I combine 1 and 0 to form 10, then 1 and 1, 1 and 2, 1, 3, 13, 1, 4, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 and 19. 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19 and so on. So, which will be the largest two-digit number? Till 99, we use the digits twice. So, they are called two-digit numbers. What is after 99? 100. 100 has three digits. 1, 0, 0. I have used the digits thrice. 100, 101, 102. I have used the digits thrice, which means three times. So these numbers are called three digit numbers. So till 999 are the three digit numbers. What is after 999? It is 1000, where 1000 has four digits. 1000. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 times have used the digits to form the 4 digit number. So after 1000, 1001, 1002, 1003, etc. till, which will be the largest 4 digit number? The largest number is 9. If I write the number 9 4 times, which will be the largest 4 digit number. So in this chapter, you are learning up to 4 digit numbers. So now tell me, which is the smallest one digit number? 1 is the smallest one digit number and 9 is the largest one digit number. 10 is the smallest two digit number and 99 is the largest two digit number. 100 is the smallest three digit number and 999 is the largest three digit number. 1000 is the smallest four digit number and the largest four digit number is 9999. Next, we are going to see about abacus. Abacus is an aid used to represent numbers. An abacus has spikes and a base. This is called the 1 spike. This is called the 10 spike. And this is called the 100 spike. And this spike is called 1000 spike. Since there is already one T, we use TH to represent thousands. Now, I am going to represent the numbers on the abacus. See, for example, we use beads to represent numbers. So if it is number 1, I add 1 bead to the ones place. If it is number 2, I add 2 beads. Number 3, number 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And can I add a number, another spike to the ones place? No, because in one spike, we can add only a maximum of 9 beads. The 10th bead represents 10, which is a 2-digit number. So I have to remove all the beads and add one to the tens spike. So this number, which is 1 and nothing, represents the number 10. 1 in the tens place and nothing in the ones place, which represents the number 10. Next, 11. So 10 plus 1 bead in the ones place represents the number 11. So 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. For the number 20, I should not add a bead here. Instead, I should remove all the beads and add a bead in the tens place. So this represents the number 20. For 21, I have to add. So now I'm going to represent the number 90. 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. Okay. So this number, 9 in the tens place and 0 in the ones place, represents the number 90. So 90, and if I add one other bead, it becomes 91. 92. 90 plus 3, 93. 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 99. Can I add another bead for 100? No. So I should remove. What do I do always do? If it is comes to number 10, I remove everything and add 1 to the tens place. So here also it becomes 10 beads. So I should remove that also and add a bead in the hundreds place, which represents the number 100. So now 100, 1 in the hundreds place, no tens and no ones. If it is 101, I add 0 here. 102, 3, 4. Likewise, when it is above, when it is beyond 9, I remove all the beads and add it to the next place. So we start adding beads from the ones place and we move forward to the left side. If it is 900, so 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So this represents 900. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 990. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 999. If I want to add another bead to this, can I add bead to this? No. To this? No. To this? No. So for the number 1000, I have to remove all the beads and add one bead in the thousands place. So now the abacus represents the number 1000. If the number is 437, I should remove this and I should add 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. If it is 2437, I should add 2 beads to the thousands place. So this is all about abacus. And now I'm going to teach you how we mark periods. See, the ones place, tens place and the hundreds place together form one period called ones period. And this is called the thousands period. This is called the thousands period. To differentiate the ones period and the thousands period, we always mark a comma. So ones period, comma, thousands period. So ones period has 3 digits: ones place, tens place and hundreds place. Now I'm going to teach you how to write number names. There are 3 rules for writing the number names. The first rule is you have to read a number always in the direction of left to right. See, for example, 1743. You cannot read the number as 3471. So you will always read the number from left to right. 1743. And the second rule is marking the comma. The second rule is marking the comma between the periods. And the third rule is you always read the ones place and the tens place together. See, for example, if it is number 14, you will always read 7614. So you always read the tens place and the ones place together. You will not read as 1 tens and 4 ones. You will always read the ones place and tens place together. These are the three rules for reading or writing the number names. Now I'm going to give you an example. 3475. So the way you read the number, you just write the number name. So first you have to mark a comma. So where will you mark the comma? After three digits from the right. So you mark a comma here. Now read the number. The comma always represents thousands. So 3475. You simply write how you read the number. So it is 3000. You will not add and in between. So 475. So the three rules. I have read the number from left to right. I have marked the comma. And I have read the tens place and the ones place together. See, for example, if the number is 1005. So simple. So 1000, 0 hundreds. You will not write the 0 hundreds. 1000 and together is 5. So 1005. Next is numeral. Numeral means numbers, representing the numbers in figures. See, for example, 7219. So this is the number name. If the question is write the number name in figures means or numerals means, you will just read the number and represent it. Whenever the word thousand comes, you will put a comma. So 7000 means 7 comma. And 219, 200, 2 in the hundreds place, and 19, which means the tens and the ones together is 19. So now we have learned abacus, number names and numerals. Next we are going to learn face value and place value. To learn about face value and place value, you need to know that face value is always the same. What you see is always the face value. See, for example, 2372. The face value of 3 is always 3 and the face value of 7 is always 7. I make it as 4. Okay. The face value of 7 is 7, 4 is 4 and 2 is 2, which means the face value never changes. What you see is the same as the face value. To learn about place value, first you need to know what is a place. So you have learned the places before. So the number 4 comes under ones place, 7 comes under tens place, 3 comes under hundreds place, and 2 comes under thousands place. Now tell me, in which place is the number 3 standing? 3 is standing in the hundreds place. So place means in which place it is standing is called the place. The number 7 is standing in tens place. So the place of 7 is tens. Now place value means the place and the value of the place is 7. So the place value of 7 is 7 tens, which is equal to place value of 7 is 7 tens, which is equal to 70. The place value of 2 is 2 thousands, which is 2000. So face value of 4 is just the same. Face value means is always the same. Now I have written an example for you. Now, for this given number, we have to write both the place value and face value. I have already told you that the face value never changes. What you see is the face value. So here you see the number 9. So the place value of 9 is 9. The place face value of 5 is 5. The face value of 3 is 3, and the face value of 7 is the 7. It doesn't change. See, 7 is 7, 3 is 3, 5 is 5, and 9 is 9. Now, coming to place value. What is the place value of 9? See, before that, we will write the places. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. So, 9 ones. So, 9 ones is same as 9. So the place value of 9 is 9. So the place value of 5 is 5 tens. 5 tens, which is 50. The place value of 3 is 3 hundreds. So which is 300. And the place value of 7 is 7 thousands. So which is 7000. So are you all clear with the difference between place value and face value? Face value is just the same, and place value is the value to a place. So value to the place hundreds is 3. So it is 300s. Now the next question. Write the place value and face value of 6 in 3162. Place value of, they have given the digit of 6. So place value of 6 and the face value of 6. What is the place value of 6? Have told you place. Which is the, what is the place? Tens. So 6 tens, which is 60, is the place value of 6. And face value is always the, just the same. So 6 of, the face value of 6 is 6. Coming to the next question, write the place value of the underlined digit. Here, what is the underlined digit? It is 9. Now, what the question is, only place value, not the face value. So, what is the place of 9? Ones, tens, hundreds. So, now the place value is 900s. Place value of 9 is 900s. You can also write as 900s. Okay, next. The underlined digit is 0. The place value of 0 is always 0. The place value of 0 never changes. The face value, place value of both the face value and the place value is always the same. Okay, next question. Write the face value of the given number. Okay, the number is 9204. Simple. The face value. The question is face value. So, face value of 9 is 9. 2 is 2, 0 is 0, and 4 is 4. So this is all about place value and face value. Now I am going to teach predecessor and successor. What is the meaning of predecessor? The word pre means before. So predecessor means the number before. And when does the success comes? Success comes after hard work. After hard work. So success means after. So predecessor means the number before, and successor means the number after. What is the number before 501? The number before 501 is 500. So you will do minus 1 to get the before number. So if I subtract minus 1 to the ones place, what happens? It becomes 5. The rest remains the same. 1825. You just have to reduce 1 to the ones place. So 2228. So what is before 400? It is, if I do minus 1, you get 399. So the number before 400 is 2302 is the number before 2303. What is before 9990? So together you take, You can't find the number before 0, right? So if you take together as 90, what is the number before 90? 89. So 9989. Moving to successor. Successor means the number after. What is the number after 345? 346. The number after 1600. So here you add 1 to the ones place. 1628. If I add 1 here, it becomes 4833. 9766. 2412. So 11 plus 1, 12. 6 plus 1. So together, take it together as 0, 6 as 6. So 4507. 6 plus 1 is 7, which is 07. 4507. Now we are going to learn numbers in between. As the name says, in between. So we are going to find the number in between 342 and 344, which is, what is after 342? 343, which is same as the number before 344. So likewise, the number between 6965 and 6967 is 6000. Here if you add 1, 6966, here I add 1 and here I minus 1. So I got 6966. Okay, next we are going to learn expanded form and short form. What does expanded form means? As the word says, expand. Like a rubber band, when you stretch a rubber band, what happens? It expands. Likewise, we are going to expand the given number, which means we are going to make it big. So how can we make it big? By adding. We are going to add. Add what? We are going to add the place values. We are going to add the place values. We have already learned place values, right? We are going to make use of that and make the expanded form. So, what is the place value of 3? Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. Now, I have written the places. Now, find out what is the place value of 3. The place value of 3 is 3000s. And what is the place value of 4? 4 and hundreds. So it is 400. Place value of 1 is 1 tens, which is 10. And place value of 2 is 2 ones, which is 2. So this, the same number 3412, I have expanded it to a bigger number. So shall we add? What is 3000 plus 400? 3400. 3400 plus 10? 3410. 3410 plus 2 is again 3412. We have not changed the number, but we have just expanded it like the rubber band. Next, 2507. What is the place value of ones, tens, hundreds, thousands? What is the place value of 2? 2000. What is the place value of 5? 500s. What is the place value of 0? 0 tens is same as 0. As I told you before, the place value of 0 is always 0. 0 tens is same as 0. Now, place value of 7 is 7. So, this is the expanded form of 2507. Next is the short form. Short form, as the word says, we are going to bring the expanded form to a short form. So expanded form to short form. Here we have made the short form to a expanded form. Here we are going to convert the expanded form to a short form. As the word says short, we are going to make it short. So 3000s. So we will write the places here. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. This is just for the reference. Okay, 3000s, which means the number 3 in the thousands place. 3, 400s,
4 in the hundreds place, 100. 7 in the tens place, 7 tens. 10 means it always means tens. So 7 in the tens place and 5 in the ones place. So the number is 3475. Now 2000 plus 7. There are only two place values here. So I will first write ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. So 2000s means 2 in the thousands place. Okay. And there is no hundreds place, which means if there is no hundreds place, which means the digit is 0. Next, no tens place also. So tens place is also 0. And what is the ones place? 7. So the short form of 2000 plus 7 is 2007. Next, we are going to learn about comparison of numbers. The next topic is comparison of numbers. To compare numbers, we use three symbols. They are greater than, less than, and equal to. So, how to remember which is greater than symbol, which is less than symbol? See, the ends, it has two ends. And here it has only one end. 2 is greater than 1, right? So, this is called the greater than symbol. Here, one end, here two ends. One is less than two, right? So, one is called lesser than. This is called lesser than symbol. And this is equal to symbol. To make it more easier, we make use of an animal, crocodile. The crocodile always eats the bigger number. See, for example, here 4073 chocolates and 4012 chocolates. Which number will the crocodile eat? The crocodile's mouth will open towards this side. The crocodile's mouth will open to this side and eat the bigger number. So it eats. So the mouth opens to this side. If the chocolate is, for example, 246 and here 426, which is bigger, 200s or 400s? 400s is bigger, and so the crocodile's mouth will open to this side. Using this concept, we are going to do some problems. Now we are going to compare 642 and 176. Which is bigger? The digits are the same, three digits. So compare the hundreds place, 600s or 100? 600 is bigger. So crocodile eats 642. Next, there are four digits. So 9000s. But here 300s or 600s? 600s is bigger. So crocodile's mouth will open to the bigger side. Now 1000, 200s or 500s? 500s. So the mouth will open to this side. In this case, 428. Both the sides are the same. So the crocodile gets confused and it will stay in the middle. It will neither go to this side nor to this side. It will stand still. So we put equal to symbol. Next, we are going to learn about ascending order. What is ascending order? Ascending order is small to big. And descending order is big to small. Okay. Which is the smallest number? First, you need to compare the number of digits. 246. Here, 3 digits. 4 digits. 4 digits. 4 digits. Here, only 3 digits are there. So, which will be the smallest? So, 246 is the smallest. Next, you will compare the thousands place. 4000 or 1000 or 6000. 1000 is the smallest. So, 1372. Next, you compare 4000 and 6000, which is smaller? 4000. So 4375, and finally you have 6478. Next is descending order. Descending order means big to small. Here all the numbers have 4 digits. So you will compare the biggest place, which is thousands place. 7000s or 1000 or 3000s or 2000s. Which is bigger? 7000. So 7347 first. Next, you're going to compare these three. Which is bigger, 1000 or 3000 or 2000? 3000. So 3416. Next, this 1000 or 2000? 2400. Next is finally 1078. Next, we are going to learn complete the patterns. See, patterns means one sequence. See, here 1500, the next is 1600, 1700. What will be the next? 1800. Next, 1900. Next, I'm going to teach you, give you another example. 2453, or next is 2553. What will be the next three patterns? 2000. See, 2000 remains the same, 53 remains the same, only the hundreds place changes from 4 to 5. So from here, 5 to 6, and the 53 remains the same. Next is 2753, and next is 2853. Everywhere the thousands place remains the same and the 53 remains the same, only the hundreds place changes. So this is one type of pattern. So from 4 to 5, 5 to 6, 6 to 7, 7 to 8. The next topic is forming numbers. Using the given digits, we are going to form the greatest number and the smallest number. Okay, to form the greatest number, we have to arrange the numbers in descending order, and to form the smallest number, we have to arrange the numbers in ascending order. What is ascending order? Small to big. Okay, what are the digits given? 6, 2, 7 and 9. Using these digits, we are going to form the greatest number. So, which is the biggest number here? 9. Then 7. Then 6 and then 2. So, the greatest number we have formed is 9762. Next is the smallest number, which is the reverse. You will arrange the numbers from small to big. 2, 6, 7 and 9, which is 2679. Next, we are going to move to the next problem. Here, the digits are 7, 3, 1 and 0. For the greatest number, you will write 7, 3, 1 and 0, which is in descending order. So, next, for the smallest number, you will arrange the digits in ascending order. Okay, we will first write 0, 1, 3, 7, which is a 3-digit number. So, in that case, we are going to swap the first two digits, which is we will swap the digits 1 and 0. Now it is a 4-digit number, right? So the number is 1037. So if 0 comes in the front for the smallest number, you will swap the first two digits and form the number. So the greatest number is 7310. And the smallest number formed is 1037. Now we are going to see the greatest number and smallest number. The question is, circle the greatest number. Greatest number means what? The biggest of all. For which you need to, you learnt in the ascending and descending order, right? The same we are going to do. First we are going to check the number of digits. The number of digits here are the same. Here 4 digits, 4 digit, 4 digit, 4 digit and 4 digit. So you will check the thousands place. 2000s or 1000s or 1000 or 8000s or 3000s. 8000 is bigger. So the question is greatest number, and we circle the number 8804. For this, the next question is circle the smallest number. 6025, 1089, 5036, 8012, 3102. So check the thousands place. 6000, 1000, 5000, 8000, 3000. Which is smaller? Obviously 1000. So the question is the smallest number, and you will circle the smallest number, 1089.
With this, we complete the chapter 1, the numbers. Children, do practice all the sums in the problem sets in your Star Max textbook. Hope you all understood the topics clearly. Children, please do stay home and stay safe. Thank you.